What do you think makes a good chaplaincy program, sir? Why do you have one?
I think that the spiritual health of an organization is up there, as to me, as being one of the most important aspects of an organization. You can say a lot about the things that we do, and especially a law enforcement or military organization, where we truly rub elbows with evil every day. Our deputies see some horrific things, whether it's a traffic crash, and, you know, dealing with death or child abuse or child neglect or drug addicts or homelessness or any of those social ills that let us know that as people we're fallen or we're not perfect. And how do you deal with imperfection in a job that requires it? And the chaplains are basically our spiritual lifeline that help us deal with all those negative human acts that we're asked or tasked with addressing. We're problem solvers. And you know, who ministers to that person and that family? And because we all have faults, and we all have issues that concern us. And if you see that over and over every day, how do you maintain your perspective, your objectivity, a number of things? You know, when you're dealing with a sex offender or a sexual predator or somebody that's just abused a child, you know, remaining objective is key in our line of work. But we're humans and we have emotions, and, you know, how do we deal with our emotions? And if you don't have an outlet for that. And the other aspect, our chaplains, what I see as a good chaplain is somebody that's a good listener, that really truly cares about another individual's problems, or and a problem solver. If a deputy comes and his marriage is all torn apart, his family life's not what it should be, and where does he go for guidance? If he goes to a supervisor, does a supervisor hold that against him, or judge him based off his home life and his professional life? And a good chaplain is somebody that listens and cares, and it is a problem solver, you know, actually has some references or counseling or, you know, some spiritual guidance.
What would you say to a police chief or a sheriff who's considering a chaplaincy program? What benefits, or how would you give him some counsel, sir?
I think that you'll have the tendency to know in your organization if your morale's good or bad. You'll know about things, and not necessarily individuals, but you'll know if you have a lot of your employees that are in debt to the point where they have to file bankruptcy or can't afford their rent. You know, they can't afford child support or to feed their families, all those things that detract from doing a good job for the citizens and keeping our folks safe. Because if they're distracted with all those issues, then you've got a problem. You got a bigger issue, and you know, trying to track down what that is. You've got an outlet for these deputies or law enforcement employees and even civilians to address some of those concerns that they wouldn't go to their boss with. They wouldn't go to their supervisor with. But if left unchecked, then it's going to become an issue for the agency or the organization, because they're going to miss days, or they may leave you abruptly, and all that training and time you've got spent in them. But, you know, from a human perspective, it's about taking care of people. And I don't know how you place a value on it, but I know that there is one, and it's probably one of our most important ones.
Many years ago, sir, I understand that you were instrumental in the chaplaincy program we have here at the Sheriff's Office. What do you think has been the success to that program?
Well, it's certainly grown, and you know, anytime you bring in a new group that are non-law enforcement into a law enforcement agency, there's kind of standoffish, you know. But I think the more time that has gone by and the more acquainted our deputies get with our chaplains, they become part of the family, and it's just an accepted part of the family now that, hey, that guy's or that woman's here to help me, and they're not going to tell, you know, my secrets to anybody. There's a privileged communication there, and you know, they're willing to pray with me. They're willing to offer solutions or references or counseling, and it's one of those, not there's no tangible that you can reach out and grab a hold to, except that you have a healthier workforce, because I think our spiritual health certainly affects our physical and mental health. And it's probably, you know, if you go back to the old adage of the stool And the stool legs, it's just one of those legs that you can't live without.
And finally, sir, the chaplains as well as the deputies go through a lot of training, and some of the training is provided by the International Conference of Police Chaplains. Do you have a comment about that, sir?
I love that group. Trying to standardize with, you know, in the political environment we live, in the legal environment we live, you know, trying to standardize that, you know, coming across as non-denominational, you know, where you're not going to be very specific as far as denominations. That group provides training and resources that chaplains can go to and get training.
In summary, sir, if you, a potential man or woman, was considering chaplaincy and they stopped by and asked you for counsel, what would you tell them?
Somebody that's looking to go into the chaplaincy,
yes, sir,
that I would tell them it's a ministry. It's a ministry unlike any that you'll ever do, but it's also similar to being a pastor of a church. I mean, you have a flock, and you're basically committing to take care of that flock, and you're committing not to that organization and not to that individual, but you're committing to God that I'm going to shepherd and counsel and guide this flock. And it's a flock unlike any that y'all, because it's not like you've got a squeamish bunch here when you're in law enforcement. And it's not like that they're not opinionated and or that they're necessarily gentle. They're very firm, professional, you know, opinionated people that you're dealing with that see a lot of evil in this world. And so how do you hash that out? How do you hash that out with their beliefs and their faith or their seeking? But it's a ministry, and it's a ministry that you've got to commit to God. So it changes over time, and our ministry changes over time. But certainly those that have a passion or gift to deal with chaotic situations and very heart-wrenching situations, that this would be a line of work for them to, where they could actually get down and dirty with the other side of life.
Well, thank you, Sheriff Ashley, for taking the time and speaking about the chaplaincy and what you think makes a good chaplaincy program. And thanks again for your time, sir.
Oh, my pleasure. God bless.